I sold my soul to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. Lisa came with a few toys like a Happy Meal.
Die letzten Jahre waren für den 42-jährigen Weltstar Kanye West nicht einfach, der immer wieder mit seiner psychischen Gesundheit zu kämpfen hatte und damit seine Musikkarriere auf Eis legen musste. Aber es scheint, dass der Rapper nach einiger Zeit außerhalb des Rampenlichts seinen Frieden gefunden haben könnte.
Now that God has called me and I now have given my life to Jesus Christ and I work for God.
I read the Bible.
For real?
Yes.
Seriously, you sit and read the Bible.
Yes.
Yeah. Would you consider yourself to be a Christian music artist now?
I'm just a Christian everything.
Uh-huh.
Everything.
Now I get to work for God and he about to show out. Kanye West works for God.
Auch wenn Kanye sich schon früher mit seiner Musik immer wieder auf Jesus bezogen hat, scheint es diesmal wirklich ernst zu sein.
I want to talk about Kanye's Sunday service, because he created a church service with music that's turned into these really big weekly events. And we had David Letterman on the show, and I asked him about it, and he raved about it, actually.
He came at a really early stage when it was just inside of a rehearsal studio. Yeah, Kanye started this, I think, just to heal himself and made it. It was a really personal thing, and it was just friends and family. And he has had an amazing evolution of being born again and being saved by Christ. And he has now made it, you know, people always ask, well, what are you worshiping and what is this? It is a Christian service, like a musical ministry. It is, you know, they talk about Jesus and God, but it started off healing for him. And now it's become something that he just really wants to share for everybody else.
I didn't know what it meant to be saved. Like, I was talking about The Life of Pablo was a gospel album. Mm. And still it got a picture of a girl with a in a thong on a cover. I'm talking about this is a gospel album. But it shows you that people could want something and there's no one around standing up and saying, this is how you get it. Like it's people around us in the music industry that want to get out of debt, but ain't nobody saying this is how you get it. It's people who want to get out of being brainwashed, and they want to wake up for real, but ain't nobody saying this is how you get it. It's simple. It's the truth is right here in the word.
I know you sent your only son and you. Sent your only son to die for us, and all you ask is for radical obedience to you. We're not asking. You're not asking us to do the least. You know, people are like, well, at least how are we gonna do the least when he did the most?
Jesus walks, I say, we ain't trying to turn atheists into believers. Now I say, we are turning atheists into believers, and it'd be all offbeat and everything. I'd be like, yep.
Yeah.
There you go. Like, we just, he can make it all good for him. He meaning specifically Jesus Christ. So you don't get it mixed up with green juice and Air One. You don't get mixed up with yoga. You don't get mixed up with, but I'm a good person. Okay. That's what you're gonna say you get to the gates. Mm-hmm. But I'm a good person. Oh, take your, go on down there with that. You did not accept Jesus, but I'm a good person. And this is not dissing good people. And obviously, there's some Christians that's bad people. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, real mean. I had an auntie that was real mean. Just made me hate church. You know what I'm saying? I ain't want to be nowhere near it. My daughter, I showed her a round image from James Turrell. And she saw it. She said, that looks like church. My daughter was crying and said she needs to go to church every Sunday and it needs to be here.
I've seen him work miracles in my life. Work miracles in our life. You know, the devil presents so many flashy, shiny objects. I've seen everything that the devil could have showed you via TV, videos, car dealerships, jewelry, houses. And I tell you, nothing beats God. Nothing, nothing. And of sound mind. Nothing beats God.
I don't even need anything. I'm praying that people can see that Jesus won the victory. When I was making raps in service to the devil, talking about you a hoe, I love it, all this, I was in debt. Now that I'm in service to Christ, God is showing off. He's showing off in my life. He's showing off in my family. With God, I've been able to beat things that had a full control of me.
The devil brought me to the lowest place in my life, the lowest year of my life. And I said, this year, I wasn't gonna go one Sunday without starting a church. And that's what we did. We started Sunday service. And people came together and the choir got bigger and bigger and bigger and people started feeling what it is. And about 4 months in, I got delivered.
I was always letting that Playboy magazine that I found when I was 5 years old have an effect on my music. It couldn't never be 100% everything it could be because I had to add that in always. And it got to the point where literally I went from Jesus Walks to You're Such a I Love It. Mm-hmm. Oh, I bet you the devil was happy on that day. And where that record went, straight to what? Number one, quick. This is exactly what we want. This fit right in with whatever else we got. This fit right in.
Why did you make it?
Because I was asleep. Mm-hmm. Because I was drowned. Because I was lost.
What do you want us to get from Jesus as King?
The title right there. The fact that everyone says that. It's Christians that told me the title Jesus is King is too heavy-handed. Now people be hitting Quince like, man, when that J.R. when that's dropping? Mm-hmm. When that Jesus King dropping? So there's an opportunity where people are coming for the music, but they may leave with salvation.
People don't always go to church the first day delivered. People be in different spaces and places and they walk. And that's something I had to learn when I was delivered because I was one of them type of Christians. You doing this, you doing that, I'll see you, everything that's wrong. Just lay back. God has already won the victory. Jesus Christ has won the victory. That's why when I rap, I say he will free our people. God has freed people throughout history. And Harriet Tubman says she could have freed more if we only knew we were slaves to Instagram, to social media, to, oh, I'm about to pull up with the Draco and this man disrespected me. Ah! Harriet Tubman said she could free more if we only knew we were slaves.
Not everybody gonna make it across the gates. It's a very specific. Since we are here for the interview, let me talk about the idea of sin and repenting. When people have their own relationship with Christ, a lot of times, I got my own relationship with Jesus. It's because they know they are dealing with sins that they don't want to have to repent for. The difference, once you're delivered, everything that you do is in service to Christ. And anything that you realize wasn't in service to Christ, you will repent for. I need to repent more. I'm sure there's things where I'll look at this interview and say, was that self-serving or was that in service to Christ?
Es ist nichts Neues, wenn Musikkünstler spirituelle Erlebnisse haben. 1958 verließ Little Richard den Rock'n'Roll, bezeichnete ihn als Teufelsmusik und beendete seine Karriere auf ihrem Höhepunkt, um Diener Gottes zu werden. Der jüdisch aufgewachsene Bob Dylan wurde Ende der 70er Jahre nach eigenen Aussagen wiedergeborener Christ und veröffentlichte Alben wie Saved. Im Hip-Hop tauchte Run-DMC 1993 mit dem christlichen Song Down With The King wieder auf, während MC Hammer vollwertige Gospel-Songs wie Pray und Do Not Pass Me By veröffentlichte. Das sind nur wenige Beispiele von berühmten Stars, die selbst herausgefunden haben, dass Ruhm und Reichtum nicht die Erfüllung mit sich bringt, nachdem der Mensch sich so sehr sehnt. Das aktuellste Beispiel ist wohl Popkünstlerin Billie Eilish, die in Interviews immer wieder bezeugt, dass ihr Ruhm und Erfolg nichts an ihrer Depression verändert hat, sondern sie viel mehr entdeckt hat, wie viele andere Künstler in dieser Branche davon betroffen sind.
We're all sad as hell. All these artists, we're sad as dude. Everybody I know that's an artist, we are sad. It's the way it is.
C.S. Lewis schreibt dazu in seinem Buch: Unseren Ureltern setzte Satan in den Kopf, sie könnten wie Götter sein, könnten sich unabhängig machen, als hätten sie sich selbst erschaffen, als könnten sie ihr eigener Herr sein und eine Glückseligkeit getrennt und fern von Gott finden. Aus diesem hoffnungslosen Unterfangen ging fast alles hervor, was wir die Geschichte der Menschheit nennen. Geld, Armut, Ehrgeiz, Krieg, Prostitution, Klassen, Herrschaft und Sklaverei. Die lange, furchtbare Geschichte vom Menschen, der auf der Suche nach etwas anderem als Gott ist, das ihn glücklich machen soll. Der Grund, weshalb dieser Plan ohne Erfolg bleiben muss, ist der: Gott hat uns erschaffen, hat uns erfunden, wie ein Mensch eine Maschine erfindet. Ein Auto ist so konstruiert, dass es mit Benzin und nichts anderem läuft. Die menschliche Maschine hat Gott so konstruiert, dass sie nur mit ihm läuft. Er selber ist der Treibstoff, den unser Geist verbrennen oder die Nahrung, an der unser Geist sie stärken soll. Eine andere gibt es nicht. Und deshalb ist es sinnlos, Gott zu bitten, uns auf unsere Weise glücklich zu machen, ohne dass wir viel nach Religion fragen. Gott kann uns kein Glück und keinen Frieden schenken, die von ihm selbst getrennt ist, weil es beides nicht gibt.
I don't believe the reawakening of the Kanye saying he's having. I don't believe if I look at the last 2, 3, 4, 5 years of his life, I don't believe that this can be as night and day as it is. Do you know what I mean?
Well,
that you would be one day living your life in one way and now saying everything is for this. I'm not sure I believe it. What would you say to those people?
Well, I'd say when you go to sleep, would you agree that you are asleep when you are asleep? And when you wake up, would you agree that you are awake when you are awake?
Yeah.
Would you agree that those are two different states? People who don't believe are walking dead. They are asleep. And this is the awakening.